Hi students, welcome back. This is your teacher Miss Hifsa. Have you done your homework of your previous lecture? Let me check it. Take out your homework pages. Look at the screen. I have highlighted the nouns for you people. Look at the first sentence. My sister lost her handbag last week. In this sentence, sister and handbag are nouns. Let's identify it as well. Sister is feminine. Handbag is a neuter gender because handbag has no masculine and feminine in it. Then in the next sentence, my uncle has an appointment with the doctor. Here the two highlighted words are nouns. The word uncle is a common gender. No, it is a masculine gender. Why? Because it has its feminine, which is aunt. So it is a masculine gender. In the word doctor, can you tell me which type of gender it is? Is it masculine or feminine? No, it is common gender. Why? Because we use it for both feminine and masculine. Look at the third sentence. The king's son is a prince. Here the word king, the word son, and the word prince is noun. So the word king is used for masculine because it has its feminine, which is queen. The word son, it is for masculine gender because it has its feminine, daughter. The word prince, it is also a masculine gender because it has its feminine. The word princess, it's it feminine. Look at the next sentence. My cousin lives near us. The word cousin is common gender because it is both for female and male. Look at the fifth sentence. The woman and her husband had a meeting. The word woman and husband are nouns in them. So the word woman is for feminine and the word husband is for masculine. How many marks have you got? Mark your homework for yourself and let's come to our new topic, which is pronouns. So let's first discuss what is pronoun. Pronoun can replace a noun, or we can say it is a word which is used in place of a noun or which is used instead of a noun. The word pro mean in place of or instead of. For example, he, she, it, I, we, you, they, these are all pronouns. Here are types of pronouns. We have 8 different types of pronouns. Those are personal pronouns, reflexive pronouns, demonstrative pronouns, indefinite pronouns, possessive pronouns, relative pronouns, reciprocal pronouns, interrogative pronouns. Let's discuss them one by one. The first one is personal pronouns, a word that is used instead of a noun, like I, we, you, he, she, it, these are all personal pronouns. And you know that we have 3 form of personal pronouns, first person pronoun, second person pronoun, and third person pronoun. First person pronouns like words I and we are first person pronoun. The person who is speaking is called first person. So, I and we are first person pronoun. You is second person pronoun. The person who is listening to us is the second person for us. So, you is second person pronoun. Third person pronoun means the person or the thing which are not involved in our conversation. Like he, she, it, these are third person pronoun. Look at the examples and sentences. What is it? It is used for singular noun. What is it? The word it is a personal pronoun. What are they? They are used for plural, but here it is used for plural non-living things. Look at another sentence. It looks pretty. It looks pretty. The word it is pronoun and it is singular pronoun. They look pretty. Here they word is for plural and here it is for person, not for different things. So these are all personal pronouns. Then we have reflexive pronouns, when the action done by the subject turns back upon the subject. Like when subject do something and again we repeat the same words in the sentences and we say that it is done by that person. Self is added to my, your, him. Like different words we have as a personal pronoun. So personal pronoun we add self to it. But to singular we use self and to plural we use selves. Like our, your, them. We add selves with it. And with singular my, your, him we use self. Look at the example of reflexive pronoun. I hurt myself. I hurt myself. We can say that here the pronoun reflect itself. I hurt myself. Myself is used for the pronoun which is already used. I hurt myself. So the myself is used for the pronoun I. So it is reflexive pronoun. We hurt ourselves. We hurt ourselves. I told you as we is plural here. So we have used selves with our. Similarly, they hurt themselves. They hurt themselves. Themselves is another reflexive pronoun which shows that this act is done by the pronoun which is already used in this sentence. Then we have demonstrative pronouns. Demonstrative pronouns stand in for a person, place, or thing which is being pointed. Like when we are pointed towards someone or something, so we use demonstrative pronoun for it. And these are only four: this, those, that, these. For singular we use this and that. Like this is a car, that is a tree. So when like you can see the article a is used here because it is singular. So this and that is used for singular, while for plurals we use those and these. Like look at the examples. Osman can work with those. Those is used here for many people. Look at another sentence. These books are mine. So the word these is used for plural, which are books. Now we have indefinite pronouns. Indefinite pronouns are words which does not refer to a specific person or thing. Like they didn't specify the person or the thing. Refer to general person or thing. We didn't exactly know that who are speaking about. Like look at the example, all were drawn. All were drawn. So here we didn't know that this all word is used for whom. Whether they are female or male or boys or girls, whatever. Look at another sentence, some are born great. Some are born great. So here the pronoun some is used for a general person or general people. So here it doesn't specify the person. Another type of pronoun is possessive pronoun, as the name shows that it would be showing position or ownership or relationship. It also refers to a specific person or thing, that something belongs to someone. For example, this book is mine. So here the word mine is possessive pronoun and it shows us that this book belongs to me. Those books are yours. So here the word yours shows that these books are owned by you. The vice is hers. Here the word hers shows that the vice is a girl, or this girl possesses this vice. So this is the another type of pronoun. Then we have another type of pronoun, that is relative pronouns. It introduces a subordinate clause and takes a noun position within it. As the name shows that it would relate something to someone, relative. It would relate someone to something. Look at the examples, who, which, that, etc. Now what is a subordinate clause? You know there are two types of clauses. One is independent clause, that is main clause which can stand alone. Like if we write it separately, so its meaning would be clear. Another is subordinate clause or dependent clause, which need another clause, main clause, to have with it. Otherwise, its meaning would not be clear. So, like, look at the examples. People who lived there did not notice him. The underlying clause is subordinate clause. Like if we write it alone, who lived there? Its meaning would not be clear. So here, who is relative pronoun, and it shows that we are talking about people which are already mentioned. So it relates back to another noun or pronoun in it. Like people who lived there did not notice him. Look at another example. The prize which he received did not impress them. The prize, here the relative pronoun which is used for the prize which is already mentioned, and it is in the start of the subordinate clause. So this is relative pronoun. Then we have reciprocal pronoun. The word reciprocal means relationship, mutual relationship or relationship with each other. Like look at the definition, they refer to two or more noun in a reciprocal relationship. Like they are in a relationship with each other. Look at the example, each other and one another. Read the sentence, the brothers quarreled with each other. The brothers quarreled with each other. It doesn't, like here, each other shows that both the brothers fight with each other or quarrel with each other. Not a single one. It's not that one brother is fighting and the other is not. So both are involved. So that's why we called it reciprocal pronoun. Look at another example. They all gave evidence against one another. So all of them are involved. The word one another is a reciprocal pronoun which shows that all of them are involved. So this type of pronoun shows relationship between each other. Then we have another type of pronoun, that is the last one, interrogative pronouns, used in order to ask a question. You know interrogative sentences which have a question in them. So interrogative pronouns involves all the WH question words. Like look at the example, which of the boys saw him? The word which is interrogative pronoun because it makes the sentence in the form of a question. What do you want? What are you doing? So all WH questions are words are interrogative pronouns because they are used in order to ask questions. That's why we call it interrogative pronouns. These were all about different types of pronouns. Hope you have learned a lot, and your homework is this, that you would take out a rep page and you would write other different examples of each and every type of pronouns. Hope you would have enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.